Our main customers are the major aerospace companies, people like British Aerospace, all we're showing here at the exhibition are just two small demo units, because one of the problems in still some of the large aerospace companies is a lot of their sheet metal parts, the information is still stored in a template, and now they're converting over to CNC machining. We've developed a small machine here, they can put a template on it, and the machine will automatically follow the profile and prepare the geometric information in a form that can be fed straight into a CNC machine. So it saves an awful lot of time converting from manual manufacturing methods to automated production.
Can you get me onto Central News Desk?
These gentlemen make probes and air data probes, etc. I introduced the Franklin's to it. I'm just saying you shouldn't miss looking at Rosemount. The equipment you make is fitted on most modern military aircraft, isn't it?
It's just about all modern military aircraft.
Yes, yeah, most of the civil ones too.
That's the Mach number of instruments.
Basically, I see
total temperature.
Yes, indeed.
Now, how do you get the static
temperature? On a high speed aircraft, we don't normally.
Yes, yeah.
Well, how is this in the Concorde? They keep on showing it up.
I don't know, yes. I think we can go this way. Yes, thank you. Look at a couple of the smaller people here, if you don't mind.
Steve Berry from Endev Company, Rich Sharp.
Just tried to visit just one or two stands. It's not possible to go to every inn, of course.
It's a pleasure.
I'm conscious that he doesn't want to be on his feet for too long. We've got to be pretty kind to him.
Yeah. Nice to meet you. We'll go this way, sir.
What a light alloy these days. They're really very... They've moved on to astonishingly from...
Is it any to take them there?
No, we're just...
He's obviously... I think they're mainly aluminium or steel.
I don't know how far they've got with titanium technique yet. How are they making a titanium sheet?
Oh, quite, yes. You can buy a lot of titanium sheet for both super plastic forming and for conventional forming.
643.
Instruments, wheels,
yes.
A lot of these smaller companies, of course, are... We can perhaps walk around this way. There's a gnome engine there that I think you would well be interested in. As a...
Yes.
Oh, yes, indeed.
Don't forget it's National Exhibition Centre, remember. You're probably aware that Frank Little's here at the NEC today.
So Frank,
say, are you aware that Frank Little's here at the NEC today?
Yes, sir.
Are they in service these days?
Yes, they are.
Self-grinding, you were saying.
Oh, yes.
And of course, at the other end of the technology, we coat the turbine seals with a rub tolerant coating, so the blade tip can actually run against the seal. As you can witness, there's a one before and one after there.
And they have found a way of equalising the rate of contraction there and the temperature changing.
No, not really.
That's why they go to self-fitting.
Yeah, that's right. So there's quite a selection of hardware there, obviously.
Yes.
Some more blades there.
Yes. Are you folks working on a ceramic blade? A total ceramic blade?
We're not personally, no.
What kind of tensile strength do you think you can get out of a ceramic?
I'm really not sure. That's really not...
Show you. Yes. I know where we have some ceramic blades. I can show you. I'll get one to show you at lunchtime.
I'd like to be interested to know what kind of tensile stress and strength
from printers. Yes, too.
Because you know, in my first printing, I proposed using silicon.
Yes.
Held in my shrouds.
Yes.
They were in compression.
Yes.
Not in tension.
Yes.
Right.
Yes.
Just ask for
yes, I think.
Well, there's a lot of that.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Can you tell me anything about its strength?
The strength of them, where's our expert. We'll bring someone to talk to you about that. From the construction side, okay. Tell you the details. Okay.
I think we could give that yes. as a friend.
Yes. You want to keep them out?
Thank you.
Yes, we'll move slowly on if we can be caught up.
Right. Yes. Okay.
Thank you.
Okay. That's
most interesting. I just think that's so far.
Because the turbine entry temperature is...
Very interesting. Okay, great. Right. Yeah. Okay.
We've used the equipment which enables us to look at the size. We don't have to look at it. The focusing control here.
Clear.
Is it clear?
Yes.
It enables you to on-condition monitor.
Yeah, I saw a bit of damage on the front of it.
Sorry?
I thought I saw some damage.
Oh, you will. There is blade damage there, yes.
Yes.
I don't think it'll fly again anyway, because you know more about that than me.
Something's been through it.
Yes,
it's quite an old engine now, though. 20 years old. We started with the spring balance.
Yeah. It hasn't changed much.
I wouldn't admit that in public, but in recorded.
We'd like you to just have a quickly pause at the Institution of Mechanical Engineers, because we are the sponsoring body of this.
Yes.
Hello. Can I introduce Mr. Aaron
Dunn? Oh, nice to see you.
We've got here both a fly-by-wire demonstration, although we're gladly provided by British Aerospace, and we're dealing with membership inquiries at the other end, so we might actually press a form into your reason. So I believe you are an honorary fellow, aren't you?
Sorry. Yes, indeed.
So the institution is promoting the total.
Yes, I've belonged to mechanical engineers for over 40 years. Yes, I've been an honorary member for... 3 years.
Oh, Terry Ward.
How do you do it?
Very good of you to spare the time to come and see us.
We, of course, probably best known these days for the work we do in the flying control actuation field. As you see, an example of the work we're doing in the tornado. This is the tail arm, actually, because there are two of these, but there's a great amount of redundancy. Four electrical lanes, two hydraulic systems, plus the ability to go manual, should be.
Looks too complicated to me.
I was just thinking, it reminds me of that quote that we'll design the money simplicity out of it.
Yes, that's right, Sir William. We do simpler things as well, such as you see here. Filters, smaller actuators. That's the kit we do for the Pilatus PC9 basic trainer. But we're also on the short Staccano, the new RAF basic trainer. But we're also moving into other fields in the land system side and the naval field as well. But of course it wouldn't be appropriate to show that sort of thing here. Nice to see you, sir.
We're going in this direction, sir.
Okay. Yeah.
We will just... We just want to make a final...
Frank.
Hello, pleased to meet you.
Nice to meet you.
I'm not so sure that hotel's the right thing.
Well, I mean,
what it's going to do is...
It's the concept of it, I think, a totally reusable vehicle. We're getting stuff like
that. Oh, yes, that's what we need.
Yeah.
You're thinking of the power plant, I suppose.
Yes, but...
people like to shake your hand and then we'll leave.
Organic-based
materials, you're talking about
300 to 350 centigrade, going to metal matrices and ceramics, then you're going up to over 1,000 K, 1,200 K. But if you go to metal matrices and ceramics, then you're going up to over 1,000 K, 1,200 K. But if you go to metal matrices and ceramics, then you're going up to over 1,000 K, 1,200 K. But if you go to metal matrices and ceramics, then you're going up to over 1,000 K, 1,200 K. But if you go to metal matrices and ceramics, then you're going up to over 1,000 K, 1,200 K.
Yeah, I thought you were going to try and do it. Jim, I'm riding shotgun on this one.